Welcome back everybody, Viesti here, and I'm back with the new episode Hypercam E1, which is the latest stable version of the very much acclaimed Brazilian Google camera port. It's the Hypercam E1. If you missed the previous one that I did, you can watch the video up here. Take a look, there are some nice interesting facts, and let's focus now on everything that is new in the Hypercam E1. We are opening the Hypercam site, and as you can pretty much imagine, everything here is already in Portuguese because the Hypercam is a Gcam mod built by Brazilian modeler Gianna Rossi. So in order to do a translation, I'm using Google, so just press English. If you like my videos, you can subscribe for my channel by clicking on the subscribe button, and you can also click on the notification bell so you never miss a new video. That's the built-in Google Chrome translating option. And then we can scroll and we can just see here we have the E1 stable latest version. So let's see the changelog here. Lip aperture for aux lenses included, noise and sharpness control if available on your device. Because guys, you can imagine that the Hypercam is running on Samsung, is running on Mi 9, is running on a lot of Xiaomi phones, on OnePlus phones, so people are really using it. As they should, of course, because that's one of the best ports out there. New AWB camera keys, Pixel 4 disabled because it has problems with compatibility. Added Samsung API 2, Live HDR, ISO Max and Min Control, f2.4 and 1.5 lens aperture switch and photometry. And it's crazy, you know, if you have a Samsung phone, you can also apparently use the Hypercam E1 release. Let's open the Hypercam E1 release and see what is inside. So guys, I have installed it already on my OnePlus 7. I'm going to put the download link below the video. If you want to install this camera, just take the APK from there and download it for your respective device.
Hypercam.
Going to settings, guys. Versão Hypercam Gcam Brazil. And you can see mod version is Hypercam
E1.
Some important facts around the Hypercam. It is based on the Google Camera 6.1, which is pretty much, guys, still one of the best and one of the stable Gcam versions out there. Now, I've used 6.1, I've used 6.2, I've used 7.0, and even right now I'm using the other very good camera. This is the version 7.2. And that one is built by Euronics, guys. I made a video about it. Since I made the video, there are pretty much two more new versions. So I am also using the Gcam 7.2 by Euronics 05. The current version right now is 1.3. So that's, you know, probably the best two main cameras. And of course, I'm using also the Gcam 7 by Nova. But I do believe that the Hypercam is really killing it. And let me show you guys why. So when you open the Hypercam and you go into more and you go into settings, you're going to be bombarded with a lot of options that are simply not present on the most recent Google camera reports. One of the best features here is that you can go in HDR parameters and just enable, you know, how much frames do you want the Google camera to use when you shoot pictures, you know, with the enhanced HDR technology. That is really, really crazy, guys. With latest Google camera, you can only tweak this, you know, by the dev options, but it's not so straightforward like we have it here. So this is one of the best and main parameters. So HDR parameters, HDR plus parameters, auto exposure. You can also set the auto exposure. So I leave right now mine on auto. Creation night side, again, everything here on auto. Exposure compensation zero. HDR plus enhanced auto white balance from Pixel 2 or Pixel 3. I am using the IMX 586 because I'm having a OnePlus 7 Pro and, you know, it's running a Sony IMX 586 sensor there. Enable focus tracking if you want. Of course I did. Then of course there are some advanced options and just take a look. There are really plenty of them, guys. You can tweak it up to the best of your usage so that you get the best results. I do recommend to use the Hyper 3Q XML because that one works the best for the OnePlus 7 and OnePlus 7 Pro devices. And with that said, guys, I want to take some pics as I have here Lava Man, or let's say, you know, Earthman from the latest Spider-Man movie. So I just want to do a photo of that person. And just see the results, guys. It's just stunning, guys. At the level of details and all the focusing, it is really, really crazy. I took this photo. Before starting shooting the video, guys, and you can see, I mean, the quality and all the details are really perfect. So guys, Google Camera, Hypercam E1 definitely deserves all the attention. So going back into the settings again, because I'm using this XML and I do again recommend it for you guys. So if you're running something that is based on the Sony IMX 586, then don't hesitate and download that one. On the webpage of the Hypercam, guys, you can also find XMLs for many other devices like the Mi 9, the Mi 9T, and plenty of others. So don't hesitate, go check them out and download them. Okay. Going back into the video, you know, we have pretty much here the standard stuff. Let's just take a look again into the advanced options we have. So noise reduction, you can just go and activate or deactivate noise reduction. I'm not using that, but the thing is that, of course, you can apply a lot of customization. Now, sadly, for the OnePlus 7 Pro, if you want to use the DR2 lenses, you need to have root because you need to have a module installed that will allow you to switch lenses. Now, it's not a problem because I'm not using them right now inside a Google camera. I'm just using the main lens. Just take a look on the many options that you have here. If you go to fixes, guys, you can see you have 1000 fixes that are already incorporated. So if anything crashes, there is always an option for you to enable this and that fix that will help. Okay, going back to lips, something really forgotten from the old previous Google camera ports, guys. You can choose now lips, and let me just choose now the Hypercam lip. Now, every time you choose a different lip, you probably are expected to get different, you know, color settings, you know, different level of the AWBs. So you can really experiment with those one. The safest option here is to stay with stock Google. So let me just put in there. Image processing, guys. You can activate image processing and you can change parameters there as well. All right. And as you can see here, you even have the experimental features, you know, using Pixel 3 color transform. Now I'm not using that one. This camera here is really full of a lot of extras, guys. I do recommend you to try that one. You can use that one with the Google Camera 7 or with the Google Camera 6.2 or with the Google Camera 7.2. So it's not a problem. You know, you can just have all those cameras running at once. Let me just take some more photos. I'm just making sure that I'm using HDR enhanced. And move that one. Okay, let's just do that. Let's do a short scenery from the Spider-Man movie. Okay, something like that. I'm just focusing now on Spidey's head. All right. Okay, processing HDR because I'm shooting with 36 frames. And it's just beautiful, guys. I can tell you all the color reproduction. You can even see that there are some little tiny hairs in on Spider-Man. So maybe Spider-Man is growing some hair on his forearms. I don't know. But in the end of the day, really amazing quality. I do recommend you guys to test out this camera. I hope you're gonna like it. If you like my video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, put a like to the video, and we see each other soon enough. Bye for now and take care.